So the question that I want to ask, a little bit off subject, more SAP specific. We're going to have Hasso on later on theCUBE here. we got Reggie Jackson on too, who's coming on. You're a solid guest. You're like we call the meat on the bones. Good solid guest. Good subject matter thought leader. I want to ask you about internally the SAP. What's been his effect of late? Obviously, big discussions with his HANA project. He's got a lot of length. We don't know relative to entrepreneurship and the institute, and also the customer things going on with the R&D labs. But what's been the impact internally? SAP is something in all cylinders. Is he a part of it? What is the customer of the things he's talking about internally that we can kind of ask him? We want to get some good content out of him. It's great. It's exciting. As a founder, I mean, I'm always been blogging about being an entrepreneur myself, and Dave as well, that, you know, founders always need to stay around companies because no matter what happens, or also the VCs bouncing them out, as it happened to me before, founders are important. They said that DNA. Okay, so final question before we break for me and Q&A, Dave, final question is share with us going forward in your mind's eye. Shoot the arrow forward a couple of years, 3 to 5 years. What will the cloud environment look like? Well, how do you see it unfolding? And it doesn't have to be specifically around SAP. It could be in general marketplace, business models, technology. And his goal was to add 1 million developers to the mix.
Hey, yeah. But your goal has got to be to appeal to those individuals. This is a major challenge for a company that you know has always focused on its largest customers. And
you make a good point, but one of the other ways I look at that is if you look at the studies around millennials and how they consume software, how they actually interact, how they text, how they multitask, how they collaborate. It's very different from how we grew up when we worked within the tech environment.
Absolutely, yeah.
And there's no secret repository of kids coming out of college who are like us to use the software that we did. It's all change.
Right.
And so we are adapting to that change across our applications because those applications and those platforms need to be created with a view to the mind of the people coming out of college today. And they all grew up with the internet. You know, we grew up before the internet, provided you weren't using DARPA.
Dinesh, it's been great. We want to have you on theCUBE more. Great conversation. We'd love to add. We'd love to expand the conversation around the important platform discussion. We think it's very relevant. So if your PR handle us can make some time over the next couple of months. I'd love to have you on either remotely on theCUBE or on a peer insight. But it's great. This is the ESPN of tech. You're a tech athlete in the trenches making things happen. Thanks for coming inside.
Thanks.
Great to meet you. Thanks very much.
Okay, we'll be right back with our next guest after this quick break, and we'll be continuing wall-to-wall coverage here at SAP Sapphire. And I want to say this independent coverage would not be possible without the generous underwriting support of SAP and EMC for over the years supporting us, and we really appreciate them. And so virtual hat tip to them. We'll be right back when we in this next segment.